Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial, and today we'll be going to discuss multiple linear regression, how to solve the equation for generating best fit line, and then we'll look into polynomial regression and its formulation. Guys, so far we have seen the concept of simple linear regression, where a single independent variable x was used to model the dependent variable y. In many applications, there are more than one factor that influences the response. So guys, multiple linear regression model thus describe how a single response variable y depends linearly on a number of independent variables x. So if I talk about the selling price of a house, then that can depend on a desirability of the location, the number of bedrooms, the number of bathrooms, the year the house was built, the square footage of the lot, and a number of other factors as well. So guys, multiple linear regression model is based on some assumptions like there should be a linear relationship between the dependent variables and independent variables. Then there should be absence of multicollinearities assumed in the model, meaning that the independent variables are not too highly correlated with each other. Then your y observations are selected independently and randomly from the population. And last but not the least is residuals should be normally distributed with a mean of 0 and variance. So guys, let's quickly jump into deriving the multiple linear regression equation, as we already know that our purpose is to find out the best fit line for our data points. So guys, for quick recap, let me tell you that the equation for linear regression model is known to everyone, which is expressed as y is equal to mx plus c, or we can say it as y is equal to mx plus b as well, where y is the output of the model, which is also called as response variable, and x is the independent variable. So here m will be the slope of the regression line and c denotes the intercept. So now multiple linear regression model with predictor variables x1, x2 up to xk and response y can be written as y is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 up to beta k xk plus e. Let's transform this into matrices. So here we have a matrices for x, y, beta and error values as shown on the screen. So guys, with this compact notation, the linear regression model can be written in the form of equation as shown on the screen, that is y is equal to x beta plus e. In linear algebra terms, the least square parameters estimates beta are the vectors that minimizes y is equal to x beta plus e. Now rearranging the terms, and then error vectors is expressed as e is equal to y minus x beta. So here also, we will minimize the sum of squared error, same as we did for simple linear regression, but this time for the matrices as shown in the figure. Now it is obvious that error is the function of parameter beta. Now replacing e with y minus x beta in the equation 2, and sum of the squared error is rewritten as shown on the screen. Now guys, let's expand this equation by transposing first element of sum of squared error term, and then we'll multiply the terms to get rid of brackets. Now we have final equation 4, that is y transpose y minus y transpose x beta minus x transpose beta transpose y plus beta transpose x beta as shown on the screen. So guys, before going ahead, let me tell you a little bit about matrix differentiation, because we need that for solving our equation. So if x is equal to m into 1 matrix and a is equal to n into m matrix, then we'll use mentioned formulas. Like if we have y which is equal to a, then the partial derivative of this with respect to x will be 0. If y is equal to ax, then the derivative of y with respect to x will be a matrix A. If y is equal to xA, then derivative of this will be A transpose. And when we have y is equal to x transpose AX, then partial derivative of this will be twice of x transpose A. So now we'll find out the derivative of sum of squared error function with respect to parameter B for finding optimal solution of multiple linear regression problem. So guys, here we have to estimate beta for which the partial derivative of sum of squared error with respect to beta should be 0. Now, we'll expand partial derivative to every term. And here, we don't have beta value in first term, so derivative of that will be 0. Now, the second term corresponds to formula of finding matrix derivation of Ax. So, according to that, we'll get y transpose x. Now, the third term is equal to xa. So, we'll get derivative of this as whole transpose of x transpose y. And last term is x transpose. So, derivative for this will be twice of beta transpose x transpose x. Now, we will simply solve this by cancelling the 2 and applying transpose to both sides. And now, we have beta value with us for further computations. So, guys, now we can predict the value of y by using estimates of this coefficient. That's all I have for multiple linear regression. So, guys, if you can see the screen, we have Cartesian plane where data points are scattered in a way that looks too complex to fit the straight line on this. And if somehow we manage to fit the line, then that will be underfitting condition as it will not cover that much data points. So, what should we do in this scenario where we want to fit linear model on non-linear data? So guys, here polynomial regression came into picture. And before going ahead, let me clear one doubt what most people are having in regards to polynomial regression is that whether polynomial regression is a linear or non-linear algorithm as it doesn't generate straight line. So answer will be definitely yes, it's a linear algorithm. Well, the trick here is that when we are talking about linear or non-linear, we are not talking about the variable x, but we are talking about the coefficient, that is beta values. That's why polynomial regression is a special case of multiple linear regression. So x value can have degree of 2, 3 or anything. So polynomial regression is a process of finding a polynomial function that takes the form of f of x equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 up to beta n xn, where n is the degree of polynomial and b is a set of coefficients. Through polynomial regression, we try to find the nth degree polynomial function, which is the closest approximation of our data points. So guys, let's quickly jump into the formulation of polynomial equation. Now suppose I have an equation of y is equal to beta 0 x squared plus beta 1 x plus beta 2. Now we know the sum of squared error, that is equal to whole square of y minus y hat. Let's replace the y value with the equation what we have seen just now and find out the partial derivative for each coefficient. So guys, I have covered how to calculate partial derivative for functions in simple linear regression session. So if you don't have any intuition about this, then I'll suggest you to first look into that. I'll attach that link with this video. Okay, so now we have equation where we'll find partial derivative with respect to term beta 0. Now let's look into partial derivatives with respect to beta 1 and beta 2 as well. So guys, now to find the minima, we'll set the partial derivative to 0 as shown in the figure. Here we can represent the equation into matrix form where we'll have separate matrix for x variable, y variable and coefficient set. So if m is the degree of polynomial and n is the number of known data points, we'll get a generalized matrix as shown in the equation. So guys, this is the matrix representation of polynomial regression for any degree polynomial. So guys, before wrapping up this session, I want to share one thing that we have discussed multiple linear regression and it is a type of regression where the model depends on several independent variables instead of only on one independent variable as seen in the case of simple linear regression. So the basis of multiple linear regression is to evaluate whether one continuous dependent variable can be predicted from a set of independent variables. Or in other words, how much variance in a continuous dependent variable is explained by a set of predictors. So for finding this answer, we may use of some feature selection mechanism only to use most important independent variable for final outcome. That is nothing but the backward elimination method. So guys, do comment whether I should take that topic for you. If yes, then definitely I'll come up with separate topic of backward elimination and feature selection of regression analysis, where we'll cover hypothesis, level of significance, p-value, and different type of feature selection process. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.